What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 4 of my Ultimate Let's Play for Dragon Quest IX, Sentinels of the Starry Skies. We just got back to Angel Falls. Now we're going to go ahead and pay Aaron a visit. We got a cutscene here, so let's listen in. Okay, that cutscene's over. And it looks like our next mission will take us to the Hexagon. We passed that by earlier. And this episode, we're going to go ahead and check that out. I believe that's also where we're going to encounter our first boss. And also, Eivor is no longer with us here, so now we're flying solo. Let's see if I can bolster any of my equipment here. I've only got 48 gold. Can buy some herbs, or maybe I should get a chimera wing here. And only get one. Just in case something goes wrong, I can teleport back to Angel Falls. I'll just burn the rest on medicinal herbs here. Okay. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and make our way to the Hexagon. Have I fought this guy yet? Oh, so T. Sanguini. Look different from behind. Well, that's a good way to start things off, a critical hit. And this time I'm gonna follow the path east and south. And that will take me to the Hexagon. These guys aren't worth my time at this point. I'll fight them if I have to, but that's it. So that one guy was actually running away from me. Let's go ahead and beat this Batterfly here. Still can't one-hit knockout, though. It's only doing 1 HP of damage there. I'm able to two-hit knockout it. Okay, so, we're at the Hexagon, our first real dungeon of the game. I'll try to cover as much of the map as I possibly can, try and get all the items in the area. Path is sealed. What's this? Someone appeared behind us. And he's just walking away. Well, one of the rules in video games is you see something mysterious, you always chase after it. And 9 times out of 10, you end up paying for it in the end. But in this case, we gotta do it to, move on. on the back of this statue. Well, let's check the back of the statue. Button in the back of the neck. Another rule of video games, if there's a button to be pressed, then press it. I think that should open the door somewhere. Maybe that sealed passage is open now. And lo and behold, it is. Path divides here, so I'm actually gonna go down this way first, see if there's anything in this dead end. Another rule, if you go to a dead end, there's often a treasure. And a leather shield. I actually think I already have a leather shield equipped. I do. Yay. Oh well, I can hold on to that for future party members. So let's see, which way should I go here? Go left first. Blue treasure chest. Medicinal herb, okay. Every one of those helps. So I guess we gotta go this way to move on. And we're starting to see some enemies now. A bag of laughs. Doesn't seem too threatening at this point. Maybe we'll knock it out with two hits. And get a little bit more experience and a lot more gold. So maybe I should fight a lot of these guys here. I'm also going to try and fill up as much of the beast here as I possibly can. Another new enemy, the dragon. Okay, well, I've leveled up quite a bit, so these guys aren't doing too much damage. I believe I'm at level 5 now. Closing in on level 6. I'll ignore that dragon. We'll just move on downstairs. And the path divides here. What's this thing? A mecha mina. Wow, didn't expect it to go down that quickly. Only did 6 HP of damage and it went down. Got a feather fan. That's a weapon. I do believe my class can use that. However, it's a little bit weaker than my sword, so I'll just hold on to it. Got another bag of laughs to deal with here. These guys give out pretty good gold and decent experience. Calling for backup. Uh-oh. A wingster. Yeah, some enemies can call for backup. And, a disadvantage in. I always hate when they do that. Any game, any RPG I play, a guy brings in backup, and it's just so annoying. At least I got a mecha mina here now. This guy should go down no problem. 5 HP. Took it down. And I'm at level 6. Alright. And I get some more skill points. I'll go ahead and, let's see, I think I'll just stick with my sword here. I'm now 1 point away from getting a 10-point attack bonus with my sword. Ooh, a new enemy here. This is the Fire Spirit. I was able to knock it out in one shot. Two mecha miners now. One will go down easily. This guy only does 2 hit points of damage. Normal for these guys here. I don't think I've been down here yet. Let's see what's in here. 210 gold. Wow, nice payday there. Alright, so I think the last path to go is this one. This is going to actually start taking me back upstairs. Ooh, what the heck is that? A spirit. Okay, this guy can do some damage. Probably he goes down just as easily as everything else here. And, dead end here, so, can't do nothing there. Now I got a spirit chasing me. Got blocked by the, staircase there. Oh, but one pops up here at this mecha miner. Okay, let's just, end this guy quickly here. I might have to use an herb soon. This is getting pretty good, golden experience here. Fight this mecha miner here. This guy's flying solo, but he gets a preliminary attack, or preemptive strike, wherever you call it. There's no way to predict in this game if you're going to get a free shot or if the enemy is. Go ahead and heal up here. I'll ignore these fire spirits here. This was the way that was blocked off earlier, so I'll have to go in from this direction. Blue treasure chest with a strong medicine, which I believe is a more powerful version of the medicinal herb. I'll go ahead and fight this fire spirit. I think I need to get a little bit more experience. Let's go through the door here. Another treasure chest here. Let's see, we got a seed of deafness. This obviously will increase your deafness. Any kind of seed is good. We're gonna go up here. And who's this? Cutscene. So we'll go ahead and help her out. Uh-oh. Something's a-coming here. Okay, it's boss time, the Hexagon. Let's see if Dragon Slash can do anything to this guy. 11 damage. Well, this guy is not doing too much damage here. It actually looks like a normal attack will do just as much with the Dragon Slash, so I'll just go ahead and hack away here. Really don't have much more of a strategy than that. Just keep hammering away and heal up when you need to. Really don't have anything that can decrease his defense or increase my offense. All I can really do is either heal or attack. This guy is doing some damage now, so better heal up. Like his charge attack does more damage than the rubble rain down. I think those are his only two attacks, though. I believe so. I hope so. It's been a while since I've played this game start to finish, so I forget exactly what all the bosses do. I've only played through it completely once, and we got him there. Okay. And we finally get to level 7. 100 gold and a magic beast hide, which I believe is one of those items you can use in alchemy. Alright, so let's get out of here now. We don't have to go through the dungeon again. This is Patty. She's the one that Aaron was talking about back in Angel Falls. Okay, well, she got us out of the hexagon there, but we're going to have to make our way back to Angel Falls ourselves. And yeah, we alchemized the magic beast hide. I'm going to save my chimera wing for later. Because again, once we hit more cities, we'll be able to easily transport from city to city. So I'll probably get a bunch of those later on. Really, these guys now are just target practice. Another cruel cumber bites the dust there. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to get back to Angel Falls, then I'm going to call it quits. So, and in the next episode, we'll start making our way towards Stornway, and we'll move on to the next town. So until then, I'm T.U.G. Later, gamers.